Hi friends, today we are going to see that how we can implement interpolators and decimators using polyphase structures. We know that polyphase structures helps us in decomposing a given transfer function into smaller transfer functions. This will lead us to easy computation, faster computation. Now we will see that how actually I can implement an interpolator and a decimator using polyphase structure. So basically, first we will consider a decimator. So in a decimator, we know that I cannot apply or I cannot give the input directly to the downsampler because it will provide aliasing effect. To avoid that, we imply a filter, and that filter is given as H of Z. And then we have a downsampler D, and this is my output. Okay, so let's say my output is Y of M, input is X of N, intermediate node is V of N, and Y of M will be equal to V of M D. Okay, now this filter, that is H of Z, will be a polyphase filter. Okay, so the polyphase filter, the filter structure including the decimator, let assume D to be equal to 3. Okay, I will be using D is equal to 3. So now I will be decimating, or I will be designing a filter or decomposing the filter into three basic stages. Then my X of N will be, or my filter will look like P 0 Z raised to 3, that is the first decomposition. Then I will imply Z raised to minus 1, and I will give it to P 1 of Z raised to 3. Then I will give it to Z raised to minus 1. And finally, I will propose, or I will say that P 2 Z raised to 3. How many decompositions we have done? We have done 3 decompositions. Now, after this much is the part of the filter. Okay. Now, every value has to be decimate by a factor of 3 again. So every block or on every line, I will have a decimator of factor 3, a decimator of factor 3, and a decimator of factor 3. And after that, I'm going to add each one of them. Okay. This becomes Y of M. And this is my X of N. Okay, so this is the polyphase structure of a decimator using, it's a polyphase structure. So that means I am using the filter which is designed using polyphase structures. Okay, so you can see here the filter is polyphase, and then I have decimator. Add together, we get Y of M. It is very simple. But here, observe one thing. In decimator, we are going to drop the samples, right? So after D minus 1 samples, only I will have a non-zero sample, correct? That means the downsampler will be eliminating the input signals. And in the output, I want very peculiar or less number of samples. So what is happening? The output sampling rate is lesser, whereas the input sampling rate is higher. So my filter is operating on higher sampling rate. That means it is calculating unwanted samples also, or it is also taking consideration of unwanted samples. So convolution becomes larger. In frequency domain, that is in Z domain, if you see, it is just a multiplication. But think with the perspective of time domain, then you will have X of N and H of N. This will be H of N. So when I will be doing convolution, that time my H of N will be operating on the whole set of input samples, whereas the output does not require that many input samples, isn't it? So actually I will be require only d minus 1, a dth sample. I will be picking only the dth sample. In this case, I will be picking the third sample. That is, the first will be the zeroth sample. Then I will pick up the third sample. Then I will pick up the sixth sample, and so on and so forth. Okay, I will be dropping d minus 1 samples. So why to calculate, or why to actually have the convolution on d minus 1 samples? Okay, so what is happening is filter is working at higher data rates, whereas output does not demand that high data rate. So what we should do? So we should first downsample and let the filter operate on the downsampled rate. What I need to do? I need to interchange the positions of the filter and the decimator. If I will do so, okay, I need to use the identity. I cannot do it randomly. I need to do, because my output should not change by this change. Okay, so I will be using, we will be using identity 1. What does identity 1 says? Identity 1 demands that if I have h of z and the downsampler like this, then I can easily interchange the positions by keeping the downsampler over here, and here it will be h of z raised to 1 by d. Okay, why? Because I will modify this. Let's not confuse ourselves. Okay, let's not confuse by doing this, because it will unnecessarily confuse you. I'll not confuse you. Let us do this once. If I wanted to use identity 1, then let us specify the identity directly. Okay, and then we will go the reverse calculation, because if I write that directly, you will never understand what I did. So my identity 1 says that if I have a decimator d with a filter h of z like this, then you can interchange the position by keeping first as h of z raised to d and second as the downsampling factor d, and the output will not change. Okay, what is our case? Our case is this one, where we have h of z raised to d of downsampled by d. Okay, we have this p0s, p0, p1, p2, p3 with z raised to 3, which corresponds to h1 of z, h2 of z, h3 of z, which combinedly corresponds to h of z, right? So in our case, each of the transfer function, okay, or each of the filter represents h of z raised to d that I have to interchange. So I will be interchanging this. I'll be bringing this on this side, and I'll be taking this on the other side. Rest remains the same, because I want the output to be the same. So what is going to happen? My all decimator factors will come first, and then I will have all filters. But the filter should be now only be h of z, because when I move on the other side, my identity demands that I should have h of z. So let us do that and find a more efficient structure. Okay, so the more efficient structure will be, I will have my x of n coming in, which is first given to a downsampler by a factor of 3. Okay, again I have second input, downsampled by factor 3. Again I have the third one, because I am decomposing by in a set of 3. Then I will have p0 of z. Next I will have p1 of z, and finally I will have p2 of z. Okay, now let's add together. So we will have a, so we'll draw like this, we'll have a down sampler first, rest of the structure remains the same. So I have a delay block over here, again a down sampler, again a, okay, and I will have this to be P0 of Z now. It will not be Z cube because I want H of Z now. Here it will be P1 of Z, and finally I will have P2 of Z. Okay, and then I am going to add them all. So this gives the final structure. So this is my x of n now, and this is my y of m. So now we will be working, or our filter will be working at much more lower rate as compared to the previous one. Okay, here the filter now will be only filtering out, or the convolution will be only occurring at the nth or the dth instance, because we are first down sampling, picking up only the dth samples, making a chain of integer multiples of d samples, and then we are filtering or convolving. This is a efficient decimator structure. Now let us see how to now implement a interpolator. So the second point is interpolator. We know that in interpolator we first upsample, and then we will have H of Z, correct? Then we do filtering for anti-imaging. This is my X of N, this is my Y of M. Here also the problem is the same. The input side, the rate of sampling rate is less, and the output side, the sampling rate is high. So here the filter is also operated as high sampling rate. Second thing, we know that in interpolator, we normally insert I minus one zeros. So how many non-zero multiplication that I have to perform? I have to perform non-zero multiplication only for integer multiples of I, isn't it? So why to actually increase the time by computing or shifting the window by one rate, okay? Shifting the window by one sampling time, and the sampling time at this point is very high. Now what do you mean by shifting the window? I am again considering my convolution concept. If I am considering at a higher data rate, that means my sample has now increased, isn't it? So I will have increased the sample, and my convolution will take more time to finish up the convolution sum, because I am working at a higher data rate as compared to the input side. Okay, is it necessary? No, because we are unnecessarily wasting our time on computing zeros, isn't it? And I know that I am only having non-zero values at ith samples, isn't it? In between there will be zeros. So can I interchange? Yes, we can interchange. But how we can interchange now? Or let us make the polyphase structure first of this filter. For this we will be using the transpose structure of polyphase. So for decimator I will use the normal one. For interpolator we will be using the transpose one. In transpose one we have the input. Let's take again the example of I is equal to 3. So I will have my inputs going like this. Okay. And then this is my X of N. And now I'll be decomposing, because this is 3 level, I will be decomposing at 3 stages. Okay. And then, now here what I have to do, I have to first delay. So I will delay it once, then I will add it, then I will delay it again. And then we will add the final one. y of n, x of n. This is a normal structure in which this is my h of z and this is my interpolator. Now here we can see that my h of z is operating at higher data rates as compared to the input, okay, and it is wasting its time in convolving lot of zeros, okay. So the time taken to achieve the output is, of course, will increase. So now what I'll do is I'll interchange. So we will be using the identity number 2. What did the identity 2 says? The identity 2 says that if suppose I have a transfer function h of z ahead of an upsampler, then I can change its position. I can have an upsampler first along with a h of z raised to I. Okay, so that is what the identity 2 states. So in identity 2, okay, so h of z is greater than I, and here it is operating at higher data rates. I wanted to shuffle it, so I wanted to go back, isn't it? So this way our structure currently looks like, okay, if you compare this, it is currently looking like this. And what is z raised to I? It is z raised to 3. So here we have z raised to 3, z raised to 3, z raised to 3, isn't it? So what I am going to do, I am going to interchange these guys. Rest of the structure I'll keep the same, but I am going to interchange these two guys. And when these two guys are interchanged, what is going to happen? This z raised to 3 will now be converted to z. Okay, so let us draw the efficient structure of interpolator. So the efficient structure of interpolator looks like an x of n coming in. Then now first I will have p0 of z, not z raised to 3, because here it was z raised to 3. Okay, I'm taking it this side, so it is z. Second case is p1 of z. Third case is p2 of z. Okay, this goes to an interpolator by a factor of 3, let's say. Okay, we have assumed just a factor of 3. You can assume the factor of 4, 5 or any number. It remains the same. I'm assuming to be factor of 3 because there are some structures on which we will be only dividing in 2 stages. Okay, there are some structures. Then you will have delay. I'm purposefully drawing it very small because now I don't have space. Then I have an adder which add these two numbers. Then I have again a delay, and then we'll go to the final adder, and this will produce my y of m. Okay, so that is the structure for an interpolator. So how to draw a structure of an interpolator or a decimator? Very simple. We have to first see that what is the basic fundamental structure of an interpolator and decimator. You can implement as it is, but we have seen that there is a problem on that the filter is normally operated at higher data rates. To bring them to the lower data rate side, we use the identities, noble identities of polyphase structures. And using that identities, we have seen that we can interchange the position of interpolator and the filters and make an efficient structure. So in we have also seen that for decimator, we use the normal polyphase structure, whereas for interpolator, we will be using a transpose structure because they gives us a handy result. Okay, this is how it is been made more efficient by interchanging the positions. I hope you have understood what we have dealt with today, the structures of interpolators and decimators. Thank you.